Congressman, great to have you on the show.
Glad to be here.
The House has signed off on restricting funds for the Army Corps of Engineers to enforce gun bans on their land. And I know you've been leading the charge on this for quite a while. Tell us why this is so important to take care of.
Well, there's two steps here. I joined with Congressman Bob Gibbs earlier this year in introducing the Recreational Land Self-Defense Act, which fixes a flaw in a public lands bill that was passed in 2009. And what we have just done is through the funding bill, we have eliminated the funding line that would allow for enforcement of the gun ban that currently exists. The other piece of legislation would overturn that ban so that it didn't exist at all. So those are the parallel tracks. And the issue is, in 2009, you may recall, I had an amendment that we successfully added to a public lands bill that made it legal for American citizens to carry firearms in national parks, hunting, fishing, trapping, mm-hmm. the shooting sports, and for self-defense. We found out later that the Army Corps of Engineers, which owns or manages more than 11 million acres of those federal lands, still had a provision specifically on Army Corps land that you were not allowed to carry firearms for self-defense purposes. So what the legislation I've introduced with Congressman Gibbs does is change that so that you are allowed to carry for self-defense on those Army Corps lands. And as we await the floor action on that amendment, the appropriations bill that oversees the Army Corps land is where we withdrew that funding line for enforcement of the ban. So effectively, the ban would be overturned for the entire fiscal year.
Because we're talking about areas that are pretty remote and rural, and if a hunter or fisherman runs into some trouble out there, and they can't protect themselves, there's not many people they can rely on to help them out.
And that's the whole issue. We're talking about an area that has more than 90,000 campsites mm-hmm. and thousands of miles of isolated trails. The law enforcement capability, obviously, is very limited in some of these isolated areas. So you want to have the ability to protect yourself, and that's all this says, mm-hmm. is if you want to carry for self-defense purposes, you're not restricted from doing so.
How did you first become aware of all these gun bans on this land owned and operated by the Corps? Did you hear from hunters? Did you hear from sportsmen?
We did, and it was in direct result of the 2009 amendment that I put into the National Parks Bill, where we thought that the problem had been solved. But there was specifically a designation for Army Corps of Engineers located in a different part of the law, so that's why this loophole exists. But I view it to be an oversight. It's something that we wished would have been covered in the first place, but through the amendment that we've offered now, hopefully we're going to close that loophole, and you'll be able to carry for self-defense purposes all across those 11 million acres.
But as you were saying, this restricting on funding, just the first step. And getting that completely wiped out.
Right. It's the first step. It would restrict funding for the entire year. Hopefully, we'll pass the amendment that would do away with it entirely.
It had this whole issue on the funding restriction. It had bipartisan support, didn't it?
Absolutely. We have 73 co-sponsors, solid bipartisan support in the House. It actually passed by voice vote. So we're hopeful that this is something we'll be able to run through pretty easily and get this done in a way that there won't be any controversy and use that bipartisan support to do what the right thing is, and that's to overturn that ban.
So what can gun owners and sportsmen and hunters do to help make this all happen?
I would say continue to weigh in with your elected officials, especially members of the Senate. Every state, of course, has two, so weigh in with your two senators and continue to keep the pressure on your House members that this is something that is important. It is, in all likelihood, an oversight in the law. It's easily rectified, and we're hopeful that we're going to be able to get this done by the end of the year.
Any idea when the Senate would take it up?
Well, the appropriations bill will now go to the Senate. Whether or not they take it up by the end of the fiscal year, we don't know. But again, the larger and more important component of this is the actual Recreational Lands Self-Defense Act, which was introduced in May. That's what we need to get past, because that is a complete overturn of the ban, which would be forever.
So get those emails and those phone calls coming and keep up the pressure. That's most important.
That's right. Ask them to co-sponsor the Recreational Land Self-Defense Act.